All right, class, how you guys doing? Today is, I believe, Thursday. Tomorrow's Friday. And today's homework, 5-56, along with 5-61. And 5-56, there are two systems of equations. And if we notice, remember, you need to find the x value, the y value, and your solution for the system of equation. And your solution is x, y. All right, so here they want all three answers. So if you notice the first equation is x equals 3 plus 3y. Well, if we want to do the equal value method, I need to convert this equation, the standard form equation, into, I want to solve for x, which will make it a lot easier for me, being it being math 8. All right, so what do? We're going to solve for x. So we want to do combine like terms? Nope. Zero pairs? Yes. I'm going to subtract 9y and subtract 9y both sides. All right? And then we drop down the 2x. This is a zero. Equals, and right here it doesn't matter the order, but I'll go ahead and put negative 9y plus 11. So now I have 2x equals negative 9 plus 11. I'm going to go ahead and do the last step, which is divide by the coefficient. Divide by the coefficient. So divide by 2, not negative 2, 2. Divide this by 2, which is positive 2. Divide this by 2. So now my x is negative 9y over 2 plus 11 over 2. Remember, we are not graphing. We're just now finding the solution, the x value, the y value, without graphing. All right? So what do? They're both equal to x, correct? 2, 3, 4, 5. So now let's go ahead and do the equal value method. Set it up. Here we go. Here's your... Let's put it up here. Ready? There you go. All right, you got it. All right, so what did I tell you guys? In order to do a fraction buster, see we have a fraction. All the terms have to be in a fraction form. So there we go. Now let's go ahead and multiply by the least common multiple, which is what? Yeah, 4. Can I use 2? Yep, so set it up. Let's multiply by 2. By 2, because we're going to multiply by 2, because we're going to multiply by 2, yeah, we're going to multiply by 2, so we could get rid of these fractions. So let's go ahead and multiply side by side. Careful when you multiply a positive times a negative. Ready? Keep going. Go. Careful right here. Careful right here. Got it. Did you guys get that? Now what do? Go ahead and divide. Ready? Go. Careful. There you go. Did you guys get that? All right, now we're going to do zero pairs, right? Because we cannot combine 6 plus 6y. We cannot combine negative 9y plus 11. So let's do zero pairs. Which one? It doesn't matter. I'll do the negative 9y. Crazy. So what happens here? I get 6 plus 15y equals 0, 11. Now I could do zero pairs here, right? I'm solving for 15y, so I need to get rid of the 6. Zero pairs. Go. Got that? That's pretty good, right? Now what do? Huh? Yep. We go ahead and zero pairs. Drop down the 15y. And 11 take away 6 is 5. Now this might look a little weird. It's okay. Just keep doing the work. Here we go. Multiply. Divide by what? Coefficient by 15. This is y. 5/15. Don't forget to simplify. All right, that's it. Don't forget to simplify. See that? So my x is what? My x is, what did we say our x was? Oh, no. We actually solved for y. So we got y as 1/3, right? So your y is 1/3. Now, what is your x? So the solution. So we got there. Now we x. Now we're going to plug it in. Doesn't matter. I'll choose this one right here because it's a lot easier, right? So let's set it up. X equals 3 plus 3 times y, which y is 1/3. So remember, in order to multiply with fractions, we need to put this one as a fraction, 3 over 1, and just multiply side by side. So x is 3 plus 3 over 3. What's 3 over 3? X is 3 plus 1. And now x is 4. So now there's your x. Sorry, you can't see it. There you go. X is 4. If you're confused, just look at it. And what's your solution? 4 comma 1/3. Remember, we're not graphing. There you go. You guys got that? So look at it. Pretty good, right? It's easy. It's easy. It's not that difficult. Here we go. See? This is all we did. Look at it. All we did is put this equation into x. Then we did the equal value method. All right, man. It's what time is it? 4:30. All right? And there you go. You simplified. You simplified. Then we substituted. Okay? Right here. And we got this from right here. X equals 3 plus 3y. There's your y. And we're done. We're done. Now let's go ahead and do B. 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 X minus y over 2 equals negative 1. All right. So now here's a different problem. It's a little confusing, but just bear with me. See, you got an x minus y over 2. Oh, man, y over 2? Why don't we solve for x here, right? So x minus y over 2 is equal to negative 1. So let's, why don't we do zero pairs? See that? That's a zero pair. Ooh, let me zoom in. Okay, so that'll give you x equals y over 2 minus 1. That was pretty simple. Now, what about this one? Why don't we solve for x? So let's go ahead and solve for x. Minus y, minus y. X equals negative y minus 7. So here you have two equations where I could do the equal value method. Set it up. There you go. We got a fraction. So over 1. Yeah. So we could multiply by what, everybody? 2 over 1. 2 over 1. 2 over 1. 2 over 1. Got it? So let's go ahead and multiply across. So right here, ready? Multiply. Multiply. What do we get here? So right here we get negative 2y minus 14 is equal to y minus 2, right? Now we're going to do zero pairs. So I'm going to do plus 2y, which gives me negative 14 equals, this is 3y minus 2. Now I'm going to go ahead and add 2. Baseball right here, negative 14 plus a 2, that's negative what? 12, which is equal to 3y, because this is your zero pair. And then negative 12 is equal to 3y divided by what? Divide by 3. And your y is negative 4. There you go. Wow. Yeah. Don't crumble. You will survive, math. Come on, everybody. You will survive. It's not that difficult. Look at it. So again, all we did is we converted these equations into the x equals. We solved for x. All right? We solved for x and then do the equal value method. And then 2 multiplied by 2 over 1, and then you solve for x. You solve for y. Now let's solve for x. Which one's easier? Well, I could do this one right here. Right, x, or you could go to the same problem, but it's the same thing. They're equivalent. So x is equal to negative 4 minus 7. Right? A negative, and then the y is negative 4 right here. So negative with the negative is positive 4 minus 7. And what's 4 minus 7? Please don't say it's 3. Don't say it's 3. It's 3. What is it? What is it? Yes, it's negative 3. So x is negative 3. What is your solution? Your solution is x comma y. What is your x? Negative 3. What is your y? Negative 4. And there we are done. We found our solution for this equation. All right. Woo. So we're done. We're done with this equation. It was a little tougher. If you're up for the challenge, this is it, man. All right, the quiz tomorrow won't be as difficult. You know, this is a little bit more challenging. But if you notice, it's all the same thing. Same thing. Now, in the back, I said we were going to do 5-61, right? So let's do 5-61. A, 3x plus 7 equals negative x minus 1. So here we go. We can't combine like terms, right? So what do we do? What do we do? What? Let's see. All right, here we go. Here we go. Plus x. 4x plus 7 equals minus 1. Minus 7. Baseball. What do we get? Negative what? Negative 8. Divide by 4. X is negative 2. There's your answer. Remember, all you're doing is solving for x. That's it. It's not a systems equation. But these two equation expressions can be. All right, let's go. Here we go. B. Here we go. Opposite. Combine like terms. So I did opposites. 1 minus 2x is 1 plus minus 2x. See? Here's your minus 2x. Plus minus 2x plus 5. 4x plus negative 3. Now let's go ahead and do combine like terms. 1 plus 5 is 6. Now let's do zero pairs. Here we go. I'll do this one. Minus six. Four X. Right here, careful. Negative three plus a negative six is a negative nine. Now we got X's on both sides, so I need to get rid of this one. So I'm gonna go ahead and put minus four X. Minus four X on both sides. So what is here? What is this one? Negative two X, negative four X, and it's negative six X equals negative nine. Divide by the coefficient, which is negative six. And your x is negative divided by negative is positive. So 9 over 6 divided by 3. And what's your answer? 3 over 2. Leave it alone. Leave it alone. Or 1 and 1 half. If you want. But most likely it's this. Here we go. C. Here we go. Ready? All right, let's do opposites. Negative 2x plus what? This is a negative 6. 2 plus what? A negative 4x. Plus, ooh, plus, a what? Negative x. Opposites, negative x and a plus 1. There you go. Now what do we do? We combine like terms, right? What can we do? Combine like terms where? Right here, 2 and 1 is 3. What else? Oh, it's long. Oh. Here we go. All right, here we go. A little bit more upbeat. All right, how about here? Negative 4x, negative 1x. Let's do baseball. Negative 4x, negative 1x. That's negative what? Negative 5x. Or add a negative 5x. It doesn't matter. They add a negative 5x. Negative 2x plus negative 6. Now let's do zero pairs, right? Zero pairs. So let's do add 5x. Add 5x. That'll give me 3x plus negative 6. Equals 3. Now the x is on the left side, so I need to get rid of the constant, which is negative 6. I'm going to go ahead and do 0 pairs again. So I'm going to add 6 to both sides. I get 3x equals what? Yep, 9. Then I'm going to go ahead and divide by what? The coefficient, which is 3. Both sides, and that's your 1. So your x is 3. And we're done. One more. One more. Look at it. Look at it. It's not as difficult. 3x minus 4 plus 1 equals. All right, here's the next last problem. All right, here we go. Opposites. Ready? Opposites. Go. Negative 4. So you're adding a negative 4 plus negative 5. There you go. So now what do we do? Combine like terms. Ready? Go. Baseball by 3. So 3x plus negative 3. Did you get that? All right, how about the next one? Combine like term. These two. Ready? Go. Baseball. Who won? By how many? 3x plus negative 5. All right. So now we're going to do zero pairs. Let's go ahead and do the x's. Ready? Go. Wait. What's happening here? What's happening here? All the x's are gone. Uh-oh. That means something. I have all real numbers or no solution. Does negative 3 equal negative 5? No. So my answer is no solution. That's it. That's it. No solution. No, 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 no solution. Replay it. Replay it. All right, I'm out. Peace. It's 4:45. Gotta go.